friends, when we have seen the photographs in the WhatsApp, the students are in one of the most promising pictures. And the club has highly appreciated your leadership. Thank you, sir. Now I have the opportunity to introduce Mrs. Gehna Mehra. She is a freelance journalist, come visiting faculty teaching at English journalism. She is a Sadie Gehna Mehra, pet friend name. Date of birth 27-1966. Educational background, she is a BA Honours in English Literature at Wilson College, Mumbai, with Mass Communication as a subject. And 1 year full-time postgraduate diploma in software application from the Rotary Academy. Her work experience has been a freelance journalist for over a decade and worked in entertainment back with the publication Times of India, Bombay Times, Property Times, Sunday Reviews, Saturday Times, Midday Metro, Screen, On Track, Suburbs and Free Press Journal. She is writing in Femina, Wedding Affairs and Viva. Online writing for Tata Nova, and she has a professional experience in teaching, works at the KC College, Bombay College of Journalism, where she is teaching Principles of Journalism and Current Affairs. In fact, I am also teaching at KC College, so we introduce each other long back. She has given a guest talks at UPG College of Management Studies, Banaras Hindu University at Banaras, and was invited to address students in Media Mantra 2010 SNDP Women's College at Jew. She was a guest of honor at Rotary Club of Thane, facilitated for the same 8 years back, and have been counseling students on topics for electives, journalism versus advertising at Abhinav College. She is also teaching at Gehna Mehra College of Management. She is a bulletin editor of Lions Club of Cosmic Pride. She is a well-known journalist, and I really find pleasure to introduce you. Thank you, madam, for coming to us. I also thank you, Mr. Sanjay Devkar, SAMNA editor. He has come all the way around. Thank you very much. And I explained to him what Rotary has done in the last 1 month. This entire structure, सगळे हे आपण बनवलेलं आहे आणि रोटरीच्या लोकांनी सगळे पैसे गोळे करून हे शाळा दिली.
तर या शाळेत मी शिकलो.
ओके. अरे
Triple talaq and its side effects in India. With stardust in her eyes, she steps into his life. To be asked to step out with just a few words, and in some cases, not even that. Today's talk is inspired by the recent ongoing topic in the media, that of the triple talaq. However, please note, we are gathered here to discuss the side effects of the eventuality like this on the mindset and psyche of those involved, like family members, children, parents, extended family, friends, and not the law per se. That is the job of the scholars and the decision makers. We are not ready to really interfere in that. We are here to talk about the fragility of marriages in all religions, no one particular religion per se. So I say, marriages are made in heaven and then mercilessly broken on earth. This statement holds true for all mankind and no particular section of society. My question is, are marriages delicate or are they strong? I'll throw this open to all of you all for discussion. In a world of instant coffee and instant noodles, can you actually end a relationship instantly, which is as deep-rooted as marriage, just so frivolously? This is something we need to dwell upon. And what better platform than this? I was recently watching the then PM debate of Arnab Goswami's show on Republic channel, and when we were deciding the topic, Bora sir and me, so I said, why not take up a universal topic like this? We had done paid news last time. The gentleman there would remember, and maybe the lady there. I recollect a few faces. So my question is, why should women live in the constant fear that the man will or may leave her any minute as he deems fit? According to the Wikipedia, this is what they have to say. Triple talaq, also known as talaq-e-biddat, which is instant divorce or irrevocable divorce, something that cannot be turned back. It is final. is a form of Islamic divorce which has been used by Muslims in India, especially adherents of the Hanafi Sunni Islamic schools of jurisprudence. The use and status of triple talaq in India has been a subject of controversy and debate, and currently is in the news channels all the time, regularly. Those questioning the practice have raised issues of justice, gender equality, human rights, and secularism. We are gathered here to neither question nor criticize this. That is not our agenda for today. The debate has involved the government of India and the Supreme Court, and is connected to the debate about a uniform civil code for all religions. On the 22nd August, current 2017, the Indian Supreme Court deemed instant triple talaq unconstitutional. Three of the five judges in the panel concurred that the practice of this triple talaq is unconstitutional. The remaining two declared that the practice is constitutional, while simultaneously asking the government to ban the enacting law. So triple talaq is a form of divorce that was practiced as long back as 1400 years ago by a man or from a particular faith who could legally divorce his wife by pronouncing one word just three times, as simply as that. The pronouncement could be oral, written, or in recent times even delivered through the electronic medium such as telephone, SMS, email, or social media. The man need not cite any cause for the divorce, and the said wife need not have been present at the time of the pronouncement. So while the practice was frowned upon, it was not prohibited. But they made it slightly tricky by adding a twist there. A divorced woman could not remarry her divorced husband unless she married another man, which is a practice called nikah halala. How many of you have heard of this? How many have seen the movie Nikah? Everybody. So triple talaq is manifestly arbitrary and allows a man to break down a marriage whimsically and capriciously. It is a practice that is not mentioned in the Quran or their scriptures and is largely disapproved by Muslim legal scholars. Several Islamic countries like Pakistan, Bangladesh have banned it, although it is technically legal in Sunni Islamic jurisprudence. Triple talaq in Islamic law is based upon the belief that the husband has the right to dismiss or reject his wife if he feels that the grounds are good. So, 22 of the countries, major countries, have already banned this. In the year 2016, AIMPLP, check the full form, had filed an affidavit in the Supreme Court as a response to petitions by a lady called Shayara Bano and others who were opposing the triple talaq. It stated that Sharia grants right to divorce to husbands because men have greater power of decision making. Now this will be one of the points of our discussion, and it has nothing to do with Islam or somebody being Hindu, Muslim, Sikh or Isai. The government has set up a ministerial committee to consider a legislation to put an end to the instant triple talaq. The court said that until the government formulates a law regarding this, there would be an injunction against husbands pronouncing this on their wives. Like I said earlier, today we are not here to discuss the law. Rather, we will dwell on the side effects of this age-old practice, which is in our day-to-day lives. Before I go further, I would like to ask each of you to give me your viewpoints and make this session interactive. In most marriages, at one point or the other, my observation is that one partner or the other stages a walkout. I wonder why. Isn't this exactly what we desperately wanted way back, to marry that particular person? So were you wrong then about your needs and desires, or are you wrong now? Think about it. I would like to mention here that marriage is a beautiful institution designed to tackle many human needs and in the autumn of one's life to keep away loneliness and depression at bay, something that our country has. Marriage is a partnership and needs to be respected, just like you would in any partnership be where all partners are equal. I would like to conclude this with the lines applicable to all married couples. Don't walk ahead of me, I may not follow. Don't walk behind me, I may not lead. Walk beside me and be my friend, and let's grow old together. And lastly, in global interest, I would say, save the tigers, save the trees, save the rivers, and save the marriages. Thank you.